bring you the conclusion of that semi-final shortly, but right now at 8:30 on Olympic breakfast time.
Laps to go in the second semi-final of the 10,000 metres, but Taieb, the young Moroccan, is the man in front. He's only 21. In second place, Tanui of Kenya. Third is Prieto of Spain. Fourth, Arpan of France. Fifth, Kunze of East Germany. Sixth, Yonishigi of Japan. And just behind him, Eamon Martin of Great Britain. There's seven there, and Kova back in eighth place, and Eamon Martin fairly secure for a qualifier.
Well, he's done well to stay in the group there. They whittled him down from 15 down to 10 and then to 8. And he managed to go past Kova, the reigning Olympic champion, who's now about 30 metres behind Eamon. So Eamon's got that buffer of 30 metres or so to 8th place and Alberto Kova. I wouldn't have fancied his chances in the last lap against Kova in his heyday, but I think he'd be all right today. But I think Butaib and Moses Tanui, the Butaib who's trains with Awita and he seems quite happy and accustomed to running in these kinds of conditions. He seems smooth, very silken, and running very, very nicely. And Eamon's working a little. I don't think Eamon's enjoying this, but remember, this is only his second 10,000 meter race ever. The last one was on a cool night in July in Oslo, where he broke the British record. And there's a little bit of a difference between running a race where you're going to break a British record and one where all you've got to do is get round in the first eight and qualify for the final of the Olympic Games. Kunze in fourth place. I spoke to Kova yesterday and he said Kunze was the one he was a bit worried about, but it looks like if Alberto Kova, the reigning champion, doesn't put a spurt on over the last two laps, then he's going to have a real problem in qualifying, because the first heat was a lot faster than this one. But Butaib looks really good and he's only young. We've seen him run all kinds of distances this year, and I'm impressed with his running at every distance, and I'm pretty impressed with his 10,000 too, David.
I agree. Mid-season, I thought he was doing too much for a youngster. Actually, he's grown 2 years in the last 6 months, by the way. He started the season at 19. He now emerges as a 21-year-old. But he's certainly very, very promising indeed. He ran several hard races back-to-back on the European Tour. It seemed a little bit too much for a youngster, but because these really are grueling races. I have no illusions about that. But they have some recovery time now with two rest days before the final, which takes place on Monday. So in this 10,000 metres, the leader comes round with the lap marker showing two to go. Kenyan Tanui in second place. Kunze is now third. Prieto, four. In fifth place, Arpan. Sixth is Yonishigi. Seventh is Eamon Martin. And then we go back quite a long way to find Gonzalez has overtaken Alberto Kova.
Well, Butaev is running strongly, and I think Eamon Martin is going to qualify comfortably. I think he should just start ease off now, take the pressure off a little, because I think he's found it a little harder than he would have anticipated, because remember, his last one was an exhilarating victory in Oslo against a really world-class field. But we're now in the Olympic Games. There's no prizes for finishing in a fast time today, because all the prizes will be awarded in a couple of days' time when they run the final.
You're saying, Brendan, that Eamon's not enjoying himself. It's my impression as well. And of course, after Steve Binns and Mike McLeod had disastrous runs before, there doesn't seem to be a weather problem here. But even Eamon here looks, Eamon Martin looks a little heavy.
I don't think there's a real weather problem. But if you look at Eamon, he works for Ford's in Dagenham, and he spent most of the summer in Britain, and the weather hasn't been like this in Britain. He's only been out this part of the world for about 10 days. And there's a tremendous difference between running in cool conditions and conditions like this.
Lovely moment there. The camera didn't catch it, but Mel Baddy, his coach, is down at trackside. And Eamon just put his hand up to him to say, I'm okay, don't worry. And Eamon Martin looking back, and I think Mel Baddy was saying to him, take it easy, because you've got nothing to win here. It's all about Monday now. So don't waste any energy. And he settled for seventh place without any doubt at all. Butaib really strutting away and enjoying a moment of glory. And there are three or four Moroccans now moving right into world class behind Awita. So Butaib eases down. Yonishigi comes into second place of Japan with a very fast finish. Butaib's going to win it though. He qualifies. Yonishigi in second place qualifies. Tanui of Kenya in third place, Kunze fourth of East Germany, Prieto Spain five, In sixth place was Eamon Martin, together with Arpin of France in seventh. And the eighth qualifier is Gonzalez of Mexico. And Alberto Cova, former European champion, former world champion, the Olympic champion, doesn't look to me as if he's qualified. He's finished about ninth, just outside the eight qualifiers. Eamon Martin looks back at the former Olympic champion now, who's been injured, and goes on his way into the final.